Right, today's mystery guest, please.
Chris, on Friday's show, you met Air Transport Auxiliary veteran Joy Lofthouse, who told us she enjoyed landing in American camps during the war because they had the best beauty products of the 1940s. Well, your not-so-mystery guest today can tell us more about these wonderful wartime fashions, as she's publishing a practical guide to 1940s hairstyles. Please welcome Miss Bethany Jane Davis.
I love that. Practical guide to 1940s hairstyles in 2015. Good morning, Bethany.
Good morning, Chris.
How are you today?
I'm wonderful, thank you. How are you?
I'm very well too, thank you so much. You sound wonderful, and what you do sounds wonderful. How did you get involved with all this?
Well, when I started hair and makeup, I just was really attracted to the classic styles of vintage. Mm. They're just so elegant, they're so beautiful, and so many of them are just so timeless. And they just make women just feel absolutely fabulous. So I just love creating them.
Now, I talked to Joy about fashion and about people nowadays. Yeah. And she says, like, she's 92 years old. She said, one of the things she can't believe is how little pride so many people take in their appearance. Because she looked brilliant on Friday at the age of 92. And when you see these hairdos and women and men as well from the 40s and the 50s, what screams at me is effort, time and effort.
Yes, there was a lot of pride in people's appearance. And especially during the war, phrases were coined by some of the hair and makeup companies that beauty is your duty. So, you know, keep up morale, keep yourself feeling great and looking great, and put your best foot forward.
Beauty is your duty. I do like that. Right.
Yeah, it's great, wasn't it? Yeah.
So tell us victory rolls. You could have victory rolls in Spitfires or victory rolls on your head.
Yes, well, this is interesting. There's a few different stories of how the phrase victory roll was coined. It's a hairstyle where the hair is rolled and pinned up against the head, and you can see into a sort of little tube at the top. Now, during wartime, this was also the name for a maneuver by the fighter planes, where they would do a little sort of spin in the air after they shot down an enemy plane, kind of like a celebration. And it's thought that this is also a relation to why the victory roll was called the victory roll.
And the thing is now, what you say is, you know, a lot of people put effort into how they're perceived via social media as opposed to how they look and who they are. And that's what it was all about back then. It was much more sincere, wasn't it?
Yeah, and there was just a fabulous sense of community spirit at that time and everyone keeping their morale up.
All right, so vintage hairstyles of the 40s, a practical guide. Are you a wavy girl if you had to go on one side of the fence or a rolls girl?
I do like some classic waves. They just look so gorgeous. But maybe if I'm in a rush, I might put it up, because that was a lot of the reason why the upstyle was so practical in the 1940s. They needed a practical hairstyle that was going to work in the factories, in the fields, and in the Navy and the Army.
Yeah, and would last as well. All right, vintage hairstyles of the 40s. A practical guide out in November. Lovely to talk to Bethany. Thank you very much, Bethany Jane Davies.